my job! That's what I do!
Straight to you from a large spaceship currently at war with mainstream science. Meanwhile, the Peanut Gallery is monitoring the rules and policy of the Ministry of Education and the Ministry of Internal Affairs as they delegate the new censorship rules in the country. And what about the new proposed gun laws to ensure a safe United States by registering and licensing firearms? Wait, that was all in the early 20th century in a free Russia. How could they ever compare early 1900s Russia to early 2000s United States? Hello, everyone, and welcome to Strange World, where the truth is often stranger than fiction. I'm your host, Mark Sargent, the creator of Flat Earth Clues, which propose that all of us are living inside a Truman Show enclosed structure thousands of miles wide. Check it out at enclosedworld.com or just Google Flat Earth Clues if you can't find it. Well, you're just not very good at that whole internet thing. For those of you listening to this on YouTube and want to hear the show live as it happens, please go to Truth Frequency Radio for the latest schedule. Currently, this show is on Tuesday nights at 7 Pacific, 10 Eastern, and yes, Caroline, if it is not January 12th, 2021, then you are listening to a rerun. Quote of the day goes exactly like this. Once a government is committed to the principle of silencing the voice of opposition, it has only one way to go. And that is down the path of increasingly repressive measures until it becomes a source of terror to all its citizens and creates a country where everyone lives in fear. Who said that? Harry Truman. He was a president, by the way. My co-host, she's lovely, she's sassy. She's sometimes sassy, but she's always lethal. And most of the time she's here. You know what? It's Karen B. Karen, what's going on?
Hey, Mark, how's it going?
You know, pretty good. Pretty good.
Good.
And I'm going to, we're going to do a little rant in a little bit. I've got a quick rant because I want to talk about, even though I know it's not until a week from tomorrow is the inauguration, I want to do a quick rant on that. And then we'll read a couple emails that people sent me about you from last week's show. But first... No, they're good. I promise. Most of them are totally good. But first, do you know what the best Flat Earth app is in the entire world right now?
Yes, I do.
I bet you do. It's the Flat Earth Sun, Moon, and Zodiac Clock app. You know, if every Flat Earther either gifted or at least shared the FE Clock app with just one person every week, the entire world would know the Earth is flat in less than a year. And I'm sure it would create world peace. Watch the featured video every day for 2 weeks and see what happens. It'll be the best $2.99 you've ever spent. Also, I'd like to mention, because, you know, the inauguration is coming up, if you guys don't have a survival guide, I am giving one out free. It is called Empty Shelves. It's in PDF format. If you want it, you can email me at msargent23@comcast.net. That's msargent23@comcast.net. And I will send it to you. You want the printed version or the audible version? That's on Amazon. Please look for it by name. You can just type in Mark Sargent Flat Earth or Mark Sargent Empty Shelves. You'll find it. Also, thank you to a very late Christmas card with cows on the front. It says Merry Christmas. It says just a little note from Australia to wish you a big flatmas. Love, Paula. And that is from Paula Bradley out in Australia. I don't know. What's NSW? Is that New South Wales? I think.
I would guess so, yeah.
I think so. Yeah. Peanut Gallery, look that up. Is NSW? I'm not going to give out her entire street address. But thank you for that. A Christmas card, that, and she didn't even know how long it was going to take to get here. If you send a postcard from Australia, still takes a while. So, I've got a little rant, and I'm going to read some emails. Are you ready? You guys, both of you, I know. By the way, after this, and, well, we'll see how many we can get through in the first segment. We have Roxanne Glenn here with us this evening. Also, she is from the UK. It is 3 a.m. Hopefully, well, we'll see if she stays up or just knocks right out after we're done with her. But looking forward to hearing what's happening over the UK and Europe.
So, yes.
Excited about that. And so you guys
get a
drink. Yeah, get a drink ready, because this is the rant only takes like 6 minutes. But I did want to get this one out there, and people were bugging me about it because they're watching all this weird stuff happen in the United States, and I thought I'd just kind of break it down for you. So here we go. The rant is called 2021 for All the Marbles. Let's start with a simple statement. Human beings have always been and always will be very competitive. We hate losing, and it applies to almost every aspect of our culture. Motivated people will do just about anything to win. You see it when professional athletes cheat, when corporations commit espionage. Just about anyone is capable of sabotaging another person in a fair competition. It's just who we are. That being said, the worst offenders over the course of history have been politicians at just about every level. Remember, their default state is to overpromise and underdeliver, and they get paid well to do so. The only difference between them and a corporate spy is that the politician hides in plain sight behind big smiles and warm handshakes. The saying, our will to win, underestimates us. Our instinct, our drive, is to dominate completely. Very competitive people don't just want to have bigger numbers on the scoreboard. They want the other guy to have no points at all. They want the other guy to submit and drop dead on the field. They want the other guy to be wiped completely from the map and to remove their memory from the record books. Many of the rules in war have carried over into times of peace. And when we apply the win-at-all-costs attitude to politics, we run into an interesting paradox, especially in America. Up until now, the general public has assumed that the red team and blue team needed each other, that they worked in tandem with checks and balances and kept each other in line. This couldn't be further from the truth. Everything you see in American politics is a series of illusions. One of the most basic layers of truth is that the red and blue teams hate each other and would love nothing more than to see their opponents disband and walk away. Until now, this wasn't possible because neither side could gain enough leverage to make the final push, the killing blow. This was mostly because neither the red nor the blue team were willing to take the big risks. Ask any military general and they will tell you, both sides being equal, the victor is usually the one willing to take steps the other won't. In other words, how far are you willing to go to win? For some, it's absolutely anything. In 2015, for some strange reason, the world started to become much more polarized. I've got some theories on specific reasons, but won't go into them here. Suffice it to say that the last 5 years have become more and more intense, no more so than in the world of American politics. Excuse me. In 2021, we have now reached the big showdown. Use whatever movie reference you want. Neo versus Agent Smith, Rocky versus Apollo, the second one where they knock each other out in the last seconds, the final scene in any big Western, whatever. One way or another, this war, and it is a war, is going to end because, well, it has to. How it ends has nothing to do with you at this stage. You are the viewer, the audience. As of today, there are only two possible outcomes, both total, both final. The blue team has thrown their final punch, and if you believe what they say, then it will land, and if it lands, it will be devastating. The blue team will control the House, the Senate, the presidency, and the mainstream media. Basically everything. With that power, they will be able to instantly start reshaping U.S. policy with no resistance, and controlling the media means that any election moving forward will also be controlled. It will be blue until the end. Let that sink in a bit. However, if you believe in the red team and their secret weapon of insurrection, then you know they might just be crazy enough to use it. If they do, then many on the blue team will be arrested as traitors in a failed coup attempt. The elections then become void, and the red team sets up a new political structure from which the blue team can never recover. The catch is that they have to use this deadly dagger before January 20th, barring any delay, because that's when the blue team will officially take power and control all agencies. So, the short version is this. Either the red team uses its secret weapon by January 20th, or the blue team wins the game forever. It's all or nothing, winner take all, last man standing. The losing team will become a footnote in American history. And that, my friends, is the long and the short of it. What should you expect to see? Well, if the blue team wins, then mainstream will embrace the coming dystopia that will transform everything you know. If the red team wins, the mainstream media will be like a hornet's nest, raging against the current administration, but that will eventually die down. We'll see if the upgraded emergency broadcast system is finally put to use. I could try to describe the strange messages your phone will get, but you'll know it when you see it. And all these things are still just plans within plans. In the grand scheme, the U.S. is still just one of the empires. There is a new world out there trying to create order out of the chaos. See what I did there? Stay alert, don't panic, and be prepared. The biggest weapon against fear is an open mind. There you go. That rant is sponsored, of course, by the letters WT and F. So, I also have a couple little things before we bring Roxanne. I'm hoping to bring Roxanne into the first segment, but if I don't, you know, please forgive me.
Okay.
Hang on 1 second.
You can't possibly have that much to say, Mark.
What?
I'm just kidding.
Oh, about you?
No.
In case you guys missed it, if you want to recap, please listen to last week's show where we had someone who claimed to be an EMT out of New York and was being extremely vague, and we gave him a lot of leeway in the first segment, and Karim tore him to shreds. She's basically just lost it on him, and which was great. It was wonderful. It was wonderful to see. So real fast, let's see here. This one
you got.
This one from a guy named Royce. I won't say the last name. Mark, I don't know how to reach Karen. However, her response to the troll you had on in the first segment of Strange World 284 was great. I was screaming at the presentation right before she tore him apart, saying about the same thing. Please let her know that she was awesome, and I admire her intestinal fortitude. Thank you. Yes, and the comments, by the way, in the if you hadn't already, if you read the comments from last week's show that I posted on my channel,
No, I haven't.
Oh my god, you really should. I mean, there people were just praising you all over the place. Look during the break if you get a chance. It was absolutely wonderful.
Okay.
Let's see what else we got. This is just a fun email I got from somebody, which was a guy named Hamad. He goes, "Dear Mark, when I eat pizza, I know for a fact that Domino's Pizza knows that I like cheese. Did I miss the flat earth? You're not the best, but the second best after Karen B." Signed, fake terrorist Hamad.
What?
Fake terrorist?
Fake terrorist. Yeah, thank you. Saying that word will get me flagged. That's fine. Let's see here. Oh, also want to promote real fast. Hi, Mark. First of all, Happy New Year. I'm asking you for a favor. I'm trying to help Billy Zagoras, or Billy Zig, author of The Elusive Curve, to get his YouTube channel across the 1,000 subs threshold so that he can go live. Billy is a good friend and a very active debater lately. Maybe you can find a way to promote him. He's currently at 879 subs, so he needs a little push. And if I click on this from a guy in Thailand, the channel is called Billy Zig, Z-I-G, and yeah. Check it out if you get a chance, please. Promised I'd do a plug on that. Also, how much time we got left for the break? I got time.
Quite a bit.
We're good.
Quite a bit.
Remember the Empire Plateau game? I want to mention to you guys, they are doing a crowdfunding deal because they're trying to get this thing off. So just look it up, Empire Plateau Flat Earth, and you will find, hopefully, their Kickstarter connection. If you mention Empire Plateau on your next show, please, of course, be grateful if you please give the Kickstarter connection a hola. The project is currently known as canceled on Kickstarter, but anyone interested can find a new link to follow under the updates tab. We are easy to find on Kickstarter. Anyone just needs to search for Empire Plateau. So look up Empire Plateau. They gave me a demo version of the game. It seems very, very cool. It's basically a chess for four people, but it's played on a flat earth map. So hopefully...
Interesting.
Yeah, I know.
Did you play it?
Well, no, because I can't get four people, you know, because of the whole COVID thing. The virus, the Rona.
Oh my gosh.
I can't, but it's basically...
Bring your game over here. Let's play it.
I know, I should. four-person chess. That's what it is. And hey, for those of you stuck at home, I think it'd be a great idea. So help them out if you get a chance. Let's see. If none of you have checked out the comments section from last week's show, please do. Karen, I've never seen so many comments in praise of Karen, and it is muchly deserved for what she did last week. And that guy never did send me an email, a follow-up.
No.
So I think he was just a guy that wanted to get on a radio show and made up something. So one last thing, which is under the radar. Let's see. So please share this on your show, maybe without mentioning my name. Okay, good. I won't. I work as a boilermaker at, I'm not going to say which dam, a company owned mine in the middle of, South Australia. Okay, so he works there. You can leave the job description out. Now you say that. Look, dude, you got to put all the stuff in the head. Otherwise, I'm going to say it. Can't just say, oh, yeah, by the way, don't read that last part.
Stay classy.
I know, right? South Australia went full lockdown like Victoria. Of course, I could probably proof these letters ahead of time. South Australia went full lockdown like Victoria late last year and sent us all home from work. Thousands evacuated over a cluster. So after sending us home, it was compulsory to have a PCR test before returning. I'm a living man with a divine spark given to me by our creator. I wasn't doing it. I looked up the PCR negative test text. See, copied it, changed my name and my phone to Pathology South Australia and sent it to myself. I created an email account and sent myself an email as well as a backup. I flew back up to work, no dramas at all, showing my text. What a joke. I actually had a great time risking my job for the truth. As you know, I fly mask-free and we'll just see what the future holds. I got land organized to start my garden. It is possible. There is a way. I want to encourage everyone to stay positive and keep in touch with our community. All the very best, as always, mate. And he wants to remain anonymous. So, yeah, which is what you and I have talked about. When it comes to the test and the vaccine, there are going to be people that are going to forge documents. It's going to be like a dystopian movie, you know, where people have to show their papers and people are just going to. All right. One more thing. You know what? I think we can bring in Roxanne just before the break. Before I bring her on, did you happen to catch any of my interview with those Brazil students?
No, I'm sorry. I did not.
He was the guy leading it was 12.
Really?
Yeah. And the other kids in the room were, I think, 10 and 9. So, and only one of them, the lead guy, spoke English, you know, a 12-year-old kid. And it was fun. He had questions. He didn't even have notes. He just fired them off, had questions for me. And he had watched Behind the Curve a whole bunch of times and could recite quotes from it very, very well. So kudos to him. And if I find the link to wherever he posted this, I mean, I copied the audio and put it on my channel. But it was fun to do. So anyway, so you know what? let's do it. Hopefully Roxanne's awake. And we will bring her in before the break right now. I'd like to introduce you. In fact, I forgot. Now she's got a new channel. I'm going to have her self-introduce. But we've had her on our show before. She is absolutely wonderful. I consider her the face of Flat Earth over in the UK. She's done some great mainstream stuff. And I had a chance to meet her when I did the UK stuff back in 2019. So without further ado, Roxanne Glenn.
Thank you so much for having me, Mark and Karen. It's a pleasure to be here again. How you doing? Happy New Year, first and foremost, to you, Karen, and all of your listeners. Hope you've had a good start to the year, despite this madness that we're all going through.
Yeah. Yeah, it's been nutty here. I'm just holding my breath basically until a week from tomorrow, because yeah. week from tomorrow, again, if your red team, if the inauguration goes through, red team, that's it. It's over. You might as well just pack it up. By the way, Roxanne's British, if you haven't already figured out, but she can do multiple accents, and we had her do them on the last show, but we won't do the whole, you know, dance monkey thing for you this show. So, but if you want to slip into some sort of pirate accent every once in a while or something really over the top, or, and by the way, don't feel bad, you can slip in British terms from time to time. like a pint.
I may do that. I may well take you up on it. Yeah, yeah. I may
or
do that.
That's not cricket or, you know, whatever. So, what protests have you been doing for the last six months?
Yeah, I think it's probably easier to say what protests haven't we been to. We've been to pretty much every protest and march and rally that's gone on over here since the summer, just before the summer actually. Yeah. And yeah, as I was saying to you before we went live, we've been pretty much playing wacky races with the territorial support group and the Met Police and the city police. Pretty much just in the belly of the beast. I will say this, shout out to all of the police across Manchester, Newcastle and all of the northern counties. The police up there have been chalk and cheese compared to the police in London. Even the police across the rest of the country have not advocated for in any way, shape or form what the police are dealing with in London. We've even seen the Met Police being a conflict on the road with TSG as well. So we've seen a conflict going on within themselves. But yeah, we've been under it. I was arrested myself. Most of the people I film with have been arrested either once, twice or multiple amount of times. Someone that's regularly on the show, Danny, he got arrested in Parliament. Another guy was arrested in front of his children. They arrested another guy and just left his dog with an absolute stranger. That's just the scratching the surface. There's been a lot. But there are still good people that are prepared to take to the streets to fight for people's freedom, despite what the restrictions are stating at the moment. So, yeah, a lot's been going on. Protests every single week.
So, and as wonderful to hear, because the Americans, as you know, and I've told you several times, have been so distracted by, and it's been very calculated. We've had some fantastically staged distractions over the course of the year to where very few people have protested at all because they've been too busy watching the theater that's been around. Right. So where do you guys, what has changed as of, I don't know, this week when it comes to lockdowns? What can and what can't you do?
So they have pretty much restricted us right back to where we were in March. They're stating that unless it's an essential journey or exercise, you can't really leave your house. They're now, you know, questioning people that are sitting on benches for too long. There was recently a case that came out in the media and was all over the place with two women that drove a few miles with their coffees just to go for a walk in the park. They both got arrested for doing that. So, yeah, we're like, this is like some different state of living that we're dealing with over here. And the mainstream media are just perpetuating that with their moral panic. The food giants over here, all of the supermarkets have ramped it up. And they've said, despite whether you've got a medical condition that makes you exempt or not, you've to wear a face mask going into the shops. Certain people have then taken advantage of click and collect. And they're now stating that you can't even go and do that without adhering to certain things that these shops have got. So yeah, people are up against it over here at the moment, that's for sure.
The police, and we have a couple minutes to the break, the first break anyway, the police over here aren't very enthusiastic, it appears, compared to what's happening over in England. Police actually will go out of their way to avoid groups if they can, but it seems that over there, especially foot cops, you know, beat cops, they seem to be very, very active. Is that pretty much is that perception right?
Say that again, my darling. Just the
cops,
up.
not over here. A lot of most of our cops drive around cars or a few on motorcycles, but not a lot except for like the major cities are walking the streets. so they don't interact. You know, it takes some more effort for a law officer here to pull their car over and get out, you know.
It's worse than that over here. What they do is just what we experienced at the weekend at Clapham Common. For anyone listening who's aware of London and the general parks, we were in Clapham Common filming a stand-up X protest at the weekend. There was 45 full-up police wagons. And these police wagons can hold up to 12 to 15 officers. And they pulled up. And this is the irony of what was going on, right? So we've rocked up to this protest. The police are literally taking out people in swathes. And not 100 yards to our right is 11-a-side football. Now, don't get me wrong. I've got nothing against football. My son loves playing it. I quite enjoy watching it from time to time. However, you've got 100 yards to the left, over 20 people playing football and people watching it with, soccer for the Americans. literally 100 yards to the right, you've got police officers clotheslining people for being part of a protest.
Wow.
And
that's crazy.
Also, we've got onlookers, muggles, as we call them, looking on, being woken up right in that very moment. Mask compliant muggles that are believing the news and everything the authorities are telling them. Are standing there going, wait a minute, why is there police having a go at those people, but those people watching the football game are all right? What's going on? Is COVID affecting them, but not them? Why are they getting arrested and not those people? It was actually onlookers from the football starting to walk over to the protest saying to officers, what's going on here? What are you having a go at these people for? Why are you having a go at these people? And you could see across the park, there were thousands of people out at the weekend. So it's like two-tier policing, like political policing. It's weird.
Totally.
Yeah, I can totally see that. I mean, yeah,
this is fascism. This is...
Oh, wait, sorry. We're going to break.
Whoa.
Karen, we'll pick that up as soon as we come back. Seriously, don't forget wherever you're going to send. Back in 3 minutes. Don't go anywhere.
No hate, no hype, no fear. We are TFR, your protection from deception.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 2 of 4. It's you, me, Karen B, and Roxanne Glenn from Merry Old England. But you know what? That was Joe Jackson. Yeah, stepping out from his album, Karen.
Night and Day.
Yes, indeed. Night and Day. So, Karen, before we were rudely interrupted by a commercial break, what was on your mind?
Oh, fascism? I wasn't really going to say anything, you know, super brilliant. I was just going to state the obvious that this is fascism. They are clearly controlling the narrative. It's blatantly in your face. They shut you up if you don't go against anything that doesn't come out of AP, Reuters, or CDC, or whatever, any sort of government, you know, governmental, whatever, authority.
Right. Yep.
And they're all lying.
Yeah. Yeah. They're not even really hiding it. I mean, it is.
No.
And I know.
At this point, it's like right in your face. And it's become very clear that everybody has to basically get some guts and be like, enough of this bullshit.
Yeah.
Or they're just going to keep doing it.
Yeah. Absolutely right. It's different, a little different over in Europe than it is here. Because over here, as you know, Karen, and maybe not Roxanne, is that if you're on the blue team, you have whatever the television says, which is half the country, whatever the television says.
Yeah, it's a mess.
It is freaking gospel. And you don't, why would you question it? They would never lie to you. And that's tough. That is difficult because, I mean, even in my own family, we have members of the blue team.
Yeah, half the country is COVID cops over here.
Yeah. Yeah. And that's all you really
like
mean.
5-year-olds, they really are. They're condescendingly talking down to us, and they are talking to us as if we are five. We had our government address us today, and basically chastised the nation on national TV.
Nice.
You know, like children that hadn't wiped their feet when they came in from the playground. We all got a chastising from the government today. And if you could hear the condescending voice of Preeti Patel as she, you know, came down on the nation and scolded us and told us if we don't do better to pay attention to these regulations, they're just going to get tougher on us.
Yeah. And oh my God. I would have thought at some point that the narrative, because people get bored easily. Now, granted, the entertainment industry has been just decimated, and so maybe people are turning to the news as entertainment. But you know, we're coming up on a full calendar year now.
Yeah.
And they just keep ratcheting it up. I mean, I don't know, Roxanne, if you heard that the news feed before we came into the show, where the United States just announced today, oh yeah, by the way, if you're coming in internationally, you have to get tested negative before you fly into the US.
Yeah, they've already got police patrolling the airports over here and spot checking people, because you've got to test for, I think it's 48 or 72 hours before flying. And if you don't, you get a £500 fine slapped on you.
Yeah. And it's only a matter of time, because the fraud has been already being rolled out. There was a wonderful story I read last week where there was this Russian, I'll simplify it, a Russian flight to China was canceled because over 100 people on that flight had the exact same doctor's note. And I mean, the exact same. You could tell it was just carboned. And
the quote that was used today was that if we do not play our part, then, in fact, I have literally a 5-second soundbite for you. Just a 5-second one.
Yeah.
If you do not play your part, our selfless police officers who are out there risking their own lives every day to keep us safe, they will enforce the regulations.
Wow.
So, but can you hear the tone of her voice? If you don't play your part, then we'll enforce those regulations on you. Do you hear me, young ladies and gentlemen?
Yeah.
And
oh my God.
Yeah. And even now, I'm just stunned. I mean, granted, you know, in our education system over here in the States, we give people the bare minimum. We do not focus on biology or chemistry or engineering or microbiology or virology. And so people don't know anything about, you know, how diseases spread and the incubation periods and how long it's supposed to last. And so
it doesn't matter if they did tell us about it, Mark, they'd freaking lie about it.
Yeah,
I know.
But that's just it. I mean, we're stretching this thing out to a year, and I'm trying to tell people, going, it doesn't take that long to infect anything. You're telling me that only 10% of the United States has been infected over a course of a year? It's like, no, that's not how it works. And anyway, so when it comes to the protests that are happening out there, what's the biggest obstacle that you're running into? Can you see the law enforcement? Are they adjusting to you, where they're coming up with new tricks to make your occupation shorter?
No, it's just the numbers. It's just a numbers game that everybody's playing at the moment. What they're trying to do is they're trying to give go home orders and dispersals before people can actually arrive at the protest. And then they're threatening people with arrest. So it's just basically a numbers game. And there's a lot of protests that being organized, and a lot of people are now probably quite weary after a few months of going out and protesting. And there is some times where they have, you know, mass arrested people. A time of which I was involved in, where over 200 of us got arrested in one go. And that's really quite deflating for people that have made massive pilgrimages to the city, whichever city they've gone to, whether it be Newcastle, Manchester, London, Bristol, Birmingham. Some people have traveled 4 miles. I had a girl on the show the other day, Paige, who took the train down from Coventry by herself to come to London, only for the protest to be broken up 20 minutes. And she's a young girl, single, working, doing her thing. And she's going, hold on, why am I not amongst thousands of other people that are awake to this? And I think that's our problem over here. There's a lot of people that are awake to this. that for whatever valid reason, and there's some people that for work reasons, there's some people that will literally lose the roof over their heads if they do something like this and get shown out for it. So there's a lot of regrouping that's going on, and a lot of people that are going out to the protests are trying to brainstorm ways to promote more people to come out. There's a lot of engaging happening on the streets, a lot of leaflets being given out, a lot of information, just like you saw with the tour. There's a lot of information with leaflets and time being spent talking to people, planting those seeds and giving them the confidence to then go and tool themselves to have the conversations with other people. But as I said, again, the social reprisals there. There are people being restricted via work. There are people being tested at work. And if they don't want to be tested, they're losing their jobs. Yeah. There are people being forced to do track and trace on their phones through work. So there's a lot of reasons why people are dropping off the cliff, if you understand where I'm coming from. There's a lot of people that are dropping out of the social media circle, and they've done so by deleting half of their phone books. I've had interactions with people out on the streets that have said, look, sorry, I have not gotten back in contact. They've pulled a completely different phone out that's like 20 years old. And they've gone, yeah, I've just got my family's numbers in here and I'm trying to pay attention online. And there's people that have completely cut themselves out of the loop just to protect their own interests as well as other people's by not putting them in the frame through track and trace.
And you know, I forgot to do this. For those Americans who don't know exactly what we're talking about here, over in UK, they're actually protesting the lockdowns directly and everything tied to the lockdowns. We're over here, you know, we did the BLM thing and then the election thing, and that's really it. Very, very few protests over the lockdowns themselves, which is really what we should have been going after, because over here, they just kind of snuck up on us. You know, it's like, oh, look what the left hand is doing. Meanwhile, the right hand is sneaking up on you. And over there, you guys knew full well what was happening, and giving it your best shot. I couldn't be more thrilled for you. At least somebody, I mean, you're really the example right now.
Mm-hmm.
Compared to like, and you know, America is not even as bad as others. I mean, Australia and New Zealand, they just rolled over and showed their belly immediately. So, I mean, more of your, have you heard any stories from other countries, friends in parts of Europe?
Yes, I have. Malta's doing a lot to get out there onto the streets and interact with people. There is a lot of places across Europe that are in small pockets, but they are up against it. They're up against the same legal forces that are up against us here in London. They really are, you know, being kind of cornered, if you will, with the police, their work, and everything else. And I think because we haven't got the major election going on that you have, there is a lot of like half of an attitude of there's a nothing burger going on other than what's going on in America. So there is people that are aware of this, but they're like, well, it doesn't really affect us over here. It's just a bit of a lockdown. And there's also those that are comfortably on furlough at the moment. And that's the worry. Yeah. There's a lot of people that are comfortably on furlough. And because of that, they're going, well, you know, I'm all right. I'm actually better off now than I was when I was working. So, and those ones, they're not really up for coming out and protesting, because as soon as they put a foot wrong, that comfortable lifestyle that they've got just now through this is going to be kind of pulled out from beneath their feet. So we're in between a rock and a hard place. But those that are going out there, I will say this, they see crystal clear the problem that is at hand. And they are trying very, you know, it's a thankless task, but they are trying very hard to try and diversify what's going on the streets so that it remains peaceful. People do want to do risk assessments with the police, which is happening successfully across other parts of the country, not so successfully in the belly of the beast. Yeah. But people are moving forward with kind of torpedo speed with regards to networking, communicating with each other across the country. I know a lot of work's been done by Rise Up Manchester, Stand Up Manchester, Stand Up Nottingham as well, up in Newcastle. Uniting the North, they've done an amazing job in uniting the northern counties and kind of put their differences aside, and they've realized that there's one common thread, and that's their civil liberties that have been taken away from them. And we were just told today by no less than Tony Blair, well, you can get your civil liberties back when you have the vaccine. He said, if you just have the vaccine, you can get your civil liberties back.
Yeah,
what? They've been taken away from us. So that is where we're at over here.
Yeah. Yeah, and again, that was my rant months ago, which is I go, the message is simple, and that is, you know, what are people willing to do to get their life back? And it is straight interrogation 101, which is you hit the pressure points, and then you say, oh yeah, we'll take away these pressure points. All you have to do is do this simple little thing over here, and most people will go for it.
You need those X-ray goggles on, Mark. You need those X-ray. They live shades on where you just see through the crap.
Yeah, and the furlough you're talking about, which is unemployment over here, they did the same thing I'd imagine that we did, where we gave unemployment benefits that were actually paying more than their actual jobs. And so what happened was people, when they're on unemployment, when they had a chance to go back to their work, they're like, yeah, I'm actually making more sitting on my couch than I am working at your factory. You can look out there. There's a lot of people, that companies that can't find workers because it's like, oh yeah, we're willing to pay whatever it is, $15 an hour, $20 an hour. It's like, no, I'm making $24 an hour just sitting here. So what do you think they're going to do? People are notoriously lazy.
And then when
lazy.
You go to work, you have to put on a stupid mask.
Damn straight. Damn straight. And let me ask you this, Roxanne, real quick, which is, over here, we, again, because Americans are notoriously lazy, I mean, you know, we practically invented junk food. I think we did, actually. Damn you, Frito-Lay. It's so tasty. people are... Oh, my God, I just lost my train of thought for a second. People are lazy, and so why? Why did I say that? Crap.
Because I was talking about when you go to work, you have to wear a mask.
Oh, yeah, that's it. So I was off into the weeds, and Karen pulled me back.
There you go. You're welcome.
Because you have to wear a mask. There's a lot of people over here that are wearing the masks just because it's like, you know what? They don't want to be hassled. Meaning if not 8 out of 10 people in the store are wearing the mask, they're not going to fight it. They're just going to wear the mask in the store. It's like, look, I got to get groceries, and I don't want to have people yell at me. So I'm just going to wear the mask. Do you run into that with a lot of people that are just going through the motions because they're, you know, going along to get along?
Two types of people out there. There's types of people that kind of wake up and they're like us and they kind of go, right, well, I'm going to go out today and go and tell people they've been lied to and space is fake and they're not living on a spinning ball flying through space. So there's people like us that kind of want it. And then there's some people that just don't want it. And I kind of get that. There's some people that just not really confrontational type of people.
Right.
And I mean that in the nicest of ways, because if you get a banner and you go out and do activism or you go out and tell people, you are kind of confrontational because you know you're going to have a bit of a triggered conversation with people. So I think there's two types of people that I'm coming across. There is people that are like, right, for passive reasons. There are sometimes they will put a mask on because they just don't want the egg when they're with their kids, or they don't want the egg when they're with their auntie, or such and such. But there are people that are like, no, that's when it's most important, when you're on your own. You absolutely have to engage. You have to tell people about the Barrington Declaration. You can't know these truths and then be passive within your daily life. That's not helpful for anybody. When you go and get your bread and your eggs in the morning, or if you're vegan and you want to go and get your oatly milk or your almond milk from the shop in the morning, then you're wasting an opportunity standing passively in a queue, not talking to your brothers and sisters behind you and in front of you. If they're wearing a mask, then just tap them on the shoulder and ask them why they are wearing a mask. You don't have to have an argument with them. Just ask them why they're wearing a mask and then let them know, do you understand there's other information out there? Because, you know, you have to understand what kind of page someone's on when you're talking to them. Because if they're not anywhere on the same page as you and they are fully immersed into this and you go flying in there with this, that and the other, they are going to think you're a lunatic. They're going to shut off and they're not going to listen to you. But you all know this, most of you that are listening that have had the space is fake conversation, you already know what those knee-jerk program response there. One thing that you might be able to see is the pattern of behavior, even if you don't recognize the words that are coming out of someone's mouth. The pattern of behavior, those program responses, those knee-jerk reactions are the same whether you're talking to someone about space, whether you're talking to someone about COVID-19.
Yeah. Tell us a little bit about, because we've been hearing mixed reports over here. You know, we started rolling out the vax pretty quick. I call it the vax. You want to call it the vaccine, that's fine. Have you been getting yours from the same companies, or are you guys doing a rollout differently?
AstraZeneca and the same ones, yeah.
AstraZeneca,
Moderna. Yeah, the same ones. They're like McDonald's. They're just franchises. They're rolling them out quick time over here. They've got massive testing centers. They've got people queuing up like McDonald's drive-thrus to get them as well.
I was thinking you guys are actually rolling out. Maybe it's the how things are set up structural-wise. but I think you're rolling it out actually faster than we are.
Possibly so.
Are you, so I mean, you have like tents sent, are they setting up at shopping centers? Are they doing big tents? Is the military involved? Yeah.
Not yet all over the country, but there are certain aspects of the military involvement in moving it around the country.
Wow.
So far.
Have you heard the rumors or whatever you know about how they're going to authenticate it? I mean, obviously you can't go in and get a shot anonymously, nor would you want to anyway. But are they talking? Is there a name for their authentication system and the tracing system? Do you know anything about that?
So yeah, I think that's to be honest, the government is pretty much chasing its tail with regards to authentication. And at the moment, then I'm assuming it's the same within your country. You've got the right to choose over there, right?
Well, right to choose what?
You have an act over there called the Right to Choose Act.
Well,
you have the right to choose. I mean, it can't be made mandatory or law.
No, it's not going to be made mandatory over here. Not anytime soon. No,
and it's the same over here as well. We've pretty much got the same thing over here with regards to having to take it. It's just aspects of people's lives that are being shut down.
Exactly. Yeah. Well, the international travel, the three things that I already said, the first things they were going to go for, that's what they're doing, which is large hospital facilities, schools, and international travel. International travel, of course, was announced today. That didn't shock me at all. Los Angeles County Schools out in LA said that kids aren't going to be able to come back unless they have it. And the large hospitals are quietly doing that. And that's a tough one for a lot of people because, you know, if you have to go in, you know, and we're talking, you know, fairly big. I know there are smaller outfits that they don't care right now. But I think that's just because no one's gotten to them yet. But the big hospitals are saying, oh yeah, you either have to be tested or you have to have vax if we have them or both. Mm. So is that where you're kind of same sort of deal?
I think that's probably where we're heading for now. I mean, they're talking about opening 24-hour vaccine centers, but then at the same time, they're saying, we don't really want people to push themselves. And if they're having to go to a 24-hour thing, do we really want? So again, They're stating one thing and doing another, but I think the cards will fall on the table where they will over the next few days. We'll find out.
Yeah. Fun. That's really, really, really fun stuff. I can't wait to see where, and it's only the second week of January.
That's right. Until then, Hancock has said that the vaccine will probably, like the flu jab, have to be renewed each year.
Yeah, and that's a bunch of crap too. It's like, really? So this novel thing, you're gonna have to get an update every. Yeah, I've heard the same sort of thing. The CDC has been, you know, the stories we've been getting, so many different stories over here. They've been, now the one I read, it was even today, said, oh yeah, the vaccine be good at least up for a year. And it's like, okay, that's convenient.
No, I can't stand it. I can't freaking stand it.
Yeah, I know.
It's bad. I'm not vaccinated myself. Disclaimer: I was born in 81. I'm not vaccinated. Neither are my children.
I remember you saying that. That's so great.
And we're fine. We're fine.
So, yeah. Exactly.
I haven't gotten one since, oh God, I was in my early teens. I think that was the last time. And I'm old. So I haven't gotten one in a long time. There was a wonderful story I read today, just this little thing where they said, they just keep announcing these things, just throwing the stuff out there and no one questions it, you know, kind of like, oh no, it's not 90% effective. It's 95% effective and there's no side effects. But the latest one was, you know, cause you have to get two shots over here. I think you have to do the same in UK, but now they're saying there's absolutely no limit to how far apart you can have those shots to get maximum effectiveness. Because I think they were worried about pressuring people. It's like, two shots, I have to go back in for a second one, you know, and people are just like, what about the time? You know what? And they didn't want to come up with, just make up some arbitrary number, like 30 days or 45 days. So they just, you know what? Whenever you want.
Why doesn't it matter? You'd think it would matter.
They didn't say. They just said it doesn't matter. They said there is no time limit between the first and second shots, only that, like, after your first one, you're only getting 47%, and the second one, you're getting 47%, which adds up.
It's not doing what they say it's doing. That's why.
I know. Yeah. Yes. Of course.
And yet, Carrie Mullis, the guy that invented the PCR test, says it's null and void. The test itself doesn't work.
It was never meant for diagnosis.
Yeah.
And he also said that Anthony Fauci was a fraud. Yeah. And that he didn't know anything about viruses or virology. Or he didn't know anything
YouTube
about what he was
down
in charge
for saying
of.
That. I played a Carrie Mullis video and then YouTube said, that's medical misinformation. We're taking you down. That's a YouTube strike. You're done out here.
Carrie Mullis was also mysteriously died two That's months right. before this whole plandemic even freaking started.
Yep.
Shocking. You know who else died right before this whole plandemic started?
Ooh.
That woman who was an ex-pharmaceutical person, and she left and she was very outspoken. Her name's right. Brandy. I can't
What's
think of her name right
on the tip of my tongue.
Yeah, but anyway, she came out and she started learntherisk.org, which tells the truth about what's in vaccines. And she even had to post on her Facebook that she's like, I do not ever want to kill myself. I am healthy. You know, basically saying if
Brandy
something
Vaughn.
Happens to me.
Brandy Vaughn.
Yes, Brandy Vaughn. Yes. Yeah. Saying if something happens to me that it's definitely foul play.
She found by her son.
Yes.
Yeah, man. That's bad.
Yeah. A year ago, it was December of 2019.
Right. Just before this all kicked off, Karen.
Yes. And Carrie, both of them.
Yeah. Off the both of them, didn't they?
There is no coincidences about that.
No, I don't believe in coincidences.
Those are the two people who could have blown the lid off this thing right from the get-go.
Yeah. And once
they shut it down before it even got started.
Yes.
Once it started rolling out, then it was pretty much unstoppable. I mean, the mainstream doctors, doesn't matter what your credentials are, mainstream doctors have tried to come out here in groups, and the mainstream media won't talk to them. They won't even show up at the conferences. They've got all, every fun fact you'd ever want about this, and they say, look, whatever you think is happening is not happening, and their message can only go so far. I mean, it's getting out in social media and here, but mainstream won't touch them because they're part of the narrative, and it's it's unfortunate.
Yeah. But
so before we go to break, I should probably get out the phone number for people to call in if anyone wants to talk to Roxanne and or Karen. Probably not me, because I know Karen's the fun one to talk to.
Right.
It's 213-233-3998. It's 213-233-3998. And be nice and forgiving with Roxanne, because right now it is just approaching, if I'm not mistaken, 4 in the morning.
That's right. 10 to 4. 10 to 4. 5 to 4. 5 to 4. 3:55.
I'm so sorry.
Don't be. Hey, I'm honored to be here. Like, literally, I had my whole nap set up ready for this. I wasn't missing for this for nothing. Really chuffed to be here. Thanks, Barry.
You actually sound very bright.
I really am.
Bright, kind, and bushy tail.
I'm gassed to be here with you both. You've no idea. I love you both dearly. I'm just gassed to be here. I love you. I'm giving you big hugs through the mic.
Gassed is good, by the way, for Americans.
Gassed is like excited for London talk. Yeah.
All right. Well, with that... we will go to our break. Remember, and I will try to pick up callers in order. For those of you who are calling, I know some of you are listening, so I will probably go with 253 first, 209 California, then go to Ohio, maybe back to California. There's someone up in Canada. No, he's just listening. Pennsylvania, more California, Louisiana, another wow, all sorts of California. You've got some fans out there, Roxanne, and or Karen.
Maybe Karen. Yeah. Who they? Maybe Karen. Come on.
Well... doesn't. Anyway, did you see, by the way, some of those comments, Karen?
A couple, yes.
Yeah. All right, we'll be back in 3 minutes. Don't go anywhere. That means you, Roxanne. Don't go anywhere.
I'm here.
All right.
Hi, my name is Ella.
You must unite what has been set aside.
We are TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
Let's roll!
Welcome back to Strange World, part 3 of 4. It's you, me, Karen B, and Roxanne from UK. So, Roxanne, you still there?
Yes, I am.
Oh, your mute button was on.
It was. My bad.
Almost a rookie mistake. Almost. And you hate to see it. All right, let's grab a couple calls. Let's see what the world wants to talk about. Let's grab 253. I think that's up near Seattle. Maybe not. 253, you listening, talking? What are we doing?
Oh, we're talking. Oh, my God, man. Anyways, the first thing I'd like to start out with is a quote for all three of you guys.
Yeah.
Cool. If you don't mind.
Sure. Dude?
Hello?
Huh?
I couldn't hear it. What was it?
I said, give me liberty or give me death.
Oh, well, good enough. Yeah. Sounds about right. There's a flag to that effect.
Yeah, Patrick Henry, so to speak.
Yeah, back in the day.
Back in the day, yes. Yeah. The next thing I was going to say is, Roxanne, thank you for your human patriotism. Same with Karen B and yours truly, Mark Sargent.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah. And people need to wake up, man, because this is insane. This is insanity.
Yep. Agreed. And it's only going to get weirder. It's going to get worse before it gets better.
Yeah. Yeah, but, and it sucks because, like Karen, you know, I got 2 kids of my own. So I think to myself, what kind of world is my children going to be growing up in, you know? And every time that question goes inside my head, I'm just like, it does not compute.
Yeah.
Do what you can to insulate them from what's happening out there, or if you can't, you know, at least give them the other side of the story if they're being bombarded by mainstream media.
Well, they're 1 in 3, so they're still
Wee
ones.
Then there's some time.
So, a little bit. Yeah, and there's some hope too.
Yeah. Yeah. Right? Yeah, exactly.
But there was one more thing I wanted to mention, which this goes towards Dottie. Man, you know what? When it comes to I forget what the guy's name is, our governor, Mark Sargent, you should know this
Ensley.
One.
Ensley.
Yeah, Ensley, that's right. You know what? We just all need to get together, and I would love to be able to go to some event that has nothing to do with this. Don't give a crap about these stupid masks and just hang out, you know, because, I mean, me, along with everyone else over this whole thing, even following this stuff and knowing the things that we know, so to speak, and, you know, it still takes its toll. And I'll tell you what,
hang tough, man.
Open a bottle of something.
Don't let it wear on you too much. I mean, it's not easy. No question. But hope springs eternal, and there's a lot of good stuff out there still to be had, and good people, like the people on this show and the people listening to this show. You're not alone. How's that?
Yeah. Well, maybe if everything gets a little bit discombobulated to where we need to come up with some sort of code phrase so that way we all understand each other, is, you know, just mention flat earth. If they go crazy, well, then that's probably the wrong group you want to be hanging out with in these future times.
Yeah, I like it. All right, man. Well, thank you. Thank you very much. And have you ever called in before? By the way, I don't recognize the number.
Yeah, I have actually. I called. I'm the maintenance supervisor. I called and I was like super. You know, you said you guys don't bite and whatnot, and I was just kind of.
Oh right.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, and then Karen scared the hell out of you last week when she jumped all over that guy.
Yeah. No.
Yeah, you know what? Good job, Karen.
I know. He was like, she was all mellow, and then all of a sudden, teeth and claws. Rawr. Awesome.
Yeah.
Anyway,
well, we need more people like Karen.
Yes, we do. Yes, we do. All right, man. Hey, thank you, and we'll talk soon. Okay.
All right, cool. Have a good one. Have a good night. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Let's jump out to California. 209, are you talking? Are we listening? What are we doing?
Hello. Audio.
Hi.
Hey, are you guys here? I'm here.
Yes.
Okay, Roxanne. Karen and Mark, what a pleasure. I'm Jason, calling from the Gold Country, east of Sacramento in California.
Hey, right on.
Tell you, right on. I first heard about Flat Earth back in 2015 when we were all trimming weed. Some kid named Juan starts talking about a dome and the sun and the moon. And, you know, I didn't really doubt it. I didn't understand what the hell he was talking about. But, you know, a couple years later, fast forward, I'm learning and I'm doing my own experiments and I'm really seeing that it's not what they all been telling me. So, and I pretty much had my epiphany when last November at San Pedro in Long Beach, looking out at Catalina Island, and the water, just like the ocean was a wall of water. Right then and there, I knew like, yeah, there's something to this. And I tell everybody, I put it on my sandwich slips, I'll write Flat Earth. And they're too afraid to even call my name. I go, you didn't even call my name. But, like you say, Mark, I so agree that it's the magic key to open up, you know, the age of Aquarius, so to speak. And yeah. I'm just thankful I'm along for the ride. And I try to share it with other people. You know, but everyone's on their own time scale and they're only ready when they're ready. But I just thank God I'm riding the wave with you guys.
Spoken like a true Californian. Awesome.
I love it.
Yeah, Michelle Gibson's supposed to do an interview with me about mud flood. Do you guys study that much?
A little.
Okay, cool. Well, I see it all around my Gold Country and everywhere I look, and it's just, it blows me away, you know?
Yeah.
Like, it's just life's one big puzzle. It's one big archaeological dig, if you ask me.
Right on.
I bet you do see a lot of that in the valley there.
Yeah, I think I heard that the city of Lodi goes down 13 stories, and this was from, like, a city worker. And,
Well, you know, course, about you know. The Sacramento, right? How there's the old Sacramento, and then there's an older Sacramento that the old Sacramento is built on top of.
Right.
And yeah.
Who knows how far it goes down? If Lodi goes down,
there's whole
stories,
theaters.
Sacramento might be the same. But...
I mean, I had people tell me that there was like an entire theater underground there. So,
wow.
Who knows?
Better believe it.
Yeah.
We're living on top of all our old dead ancestors.
Nice.
But yeah, anyway, you know, I don't want to take up too much time. My whole journey started when I used to haul logs, and my kind of like my godfather, he told me back in 2007 or so, you know, there's no such thing as a Federal Reserve. And it took my dumb ass about 10 months to finally go back to him and go, Bob, what's this all about now? And I actually woke my parents up, you know, and my mom passed away about a year and a half ago, but she got into all this and we never really talked about it, but she dug deep into the net. And I only wish I could have talked to her about Flat Earth because I know she would have been hip to it. My dad, he ain't quite so hip to it, but he's a retired doctor and he's damn near 90. So, you know, the system
owned
him for a long time, but
Right on.
Hey, man.
Cool, man.
So.
Well, thank 11, you.
11-11.
And God bless. And I'll keep listening. And I'm spreading the word.
All right, man.
Right on. Thanks for calling.
Vinity is close, brother and sisters. Okay, thank you.
Okay, bye-bye.
11-11.
I love California. I do. all right, let's go to Ohio. 937. You listening? You talking? What's crack-a-lackin'? Oh.
Hello?
Oh, there he is.
Hello?
Hello?
Hi.
Hi, were you just listening, or did you want to say something?
Oh, yes, I've been wanting to say something for weeks. I listen to you guys all the time, and I love Karen, I love Mark. I'm from Dayton, Ohio, and I'm 39, I'll be this year, and I'm really surprised I'm actually on the radio live with you guys. I love you guys, you represent the truth. I'm a true flat earth person. I do not believe in no globe earth no more. Right. All my friends think I'm crazy. And I'm a true flat earther.
Nice.
And it's an honor to be on the radio with you guys.
No, man. Glad to have you on the team.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, I tell myself this would like to be an occupation of, I would love to just do this as a dream job, hopefully I could find a way to work for you guys sometime in the near future,
very cool.
I just love to be listening to you guys, and I listen to you like every night. I really do. It's like, I'm not trying to sound obsessed and crazy, but I listen to you every night. I fall asleep.
You know what? That sounds about right, because I have a lot of people tell me that they go to sleep with me in their ears. It's just so weird to hear. Because I listen to Karen to fall asleep. That's for a completely different and more haunting reason. So
yeah. The craziest thing was the beginning of your show last week, you had stated that it was going to be riots and chaos and stuff. And you literally said that the day before. So it's like, you must be like some psychic or something. So
I just play the odds. And in this case, I don't know. I see formulas, and I've known enough plots over the years and decades that I can see this plot coming a mile away, because remember, whatever narrative they're pushing out to us has got to be for the lowest common denominator. Not the people that are listening to this show, of course. People listening to this show are enlightened, wonderful people. But the mouth-breathing troglodytes that make up the rest of the world, you have to come up with a dumb story that they can follow. Something easy. Like something from the Transformers. And that's what we're talking about. So, but thank you. No, I'm not psychic. Thank you, though.
Well, I was just joking with that. I'm just joking. But, it's an honor being on the radio show. I didn't think it was going to be possible. I'm not going to take up too much of you guys' time. Nice to finally hear from you guys.
All right.
Karen, stay welcome. And you guys have a good evening. Continue to listen to the show.
You too, man.
I'll call again sometime.
All right. I'll look for you. See you, man.
Thank you.
Bye.
God bless.
Yep. Let's go out to back over to California. We got a lot of Californians tonight. 661. You're on with you, me, and Karen B, and Roxanne from England. What's happening?
How's it going, Mark?
Hey.
Brady from Bakersfield, California.
Hey.
Hey, how's it going? Karen, I really appreciate what happened last week. That was a blast listening to you guys. last week with the guy from New York.
Oh, well, I'm glad you enjoyed that.
I think a lot of people were shocked. They were listening, and I think Karen's timing was absolutely perfect, because about the point where people are yelling at the radio, Karen just launches. Just like, let me tell you a few things, buddy. That's me being nice. Anyway, what else you got?
Yeah, just a little bit of Como and Newsom being in California to like follow like a lot of what's going on in New York. Just, you know, pretty much turning into dictators and then, you know, getting caught going out places. And I guess Como and his wife were dancing to New York on the strip on New Year's. Did you guys hear or see that?
No, I hadn't heard that.
You know, what else?
You mean on New Year's or?
On New Year's. Yeah, New Year's.
Is that the one, the woman who was wearing the mask with the pedo symbol
the
on it?
The mask with the, that's what I was about to ask.
Oh, you caught that, Karen?
That's what I was about to ask.
Yeah. Yeah.
I tried to explain it to somebody and it was just so hard.
Yeah. Yeah, they were like on stage dancing at midnight to New York. And the woman's mask had the triangle with the pedo symbol.
Nice.
The pedo symbols on it.
Yeah.
And somebody called like, no, you don't know if she really knew what those meant or if she was just, you know, mocking and wearing it on purpose while everybody was trapped inside. They were dancing to New York on the strip.
You know, I don't buy that. You know, do you have publicists and stuff? They know what that stuff means.
Yeah.
You know what that means.
I'm sure. The COVID release bill, I heard they want to release all UFO classified files within the first 180 days. Yeah. The COVID release bill also wants to give $10 million to Pakistan for gender studies.
Yeah.
And $47 million to Israel.
Course.
Yeah, it's possible. Again, it's going to be that just the first half of this year is going to be just a whirlwind of things going on. So, anyway,
Go ahead. No. Just to tie into the UFO thing. One of the Harvard professors saying, "Oh yeah, aliens are real. They've been here for."
Yeah,
that's
just funny coming from Harvard
professor.
Yeah.
But I don't want to take up too much time.
All right. Hey, I hate to do this to you, but you're breaking up a little bit. So thank you for calling in, and don't be a stranger, okay?
No problem. Thank you, guys. Bye-bye.
Bye. Let's jump out to Pennsylvania. Pennsylvania! What's happening? It's you, me, Karen B, Roxanne. She's from England, by the way. Uh-oh. Pennsylvania, are you there? Oh, Karen, I think this is one of those people that sleeps while they listen to the show.
Is it? Well, they're not snoring, so it's not any fun.
I know. 484. We get those, by the way, every once in a while, Roxanne. Someone will be on the line, and they'll be listening, and all of a sudden you'll hear this. It's really funny if you can catch it. But anyway, or they're just being shy. Let's do, heck, we're going back out to California. 530. What's happening?
Hey, Mark, Karen, and Roxanne. It is William. Good evening.
Hey.
Hi, William.
Hey. Hey, sorry, I wasn't able to. Hey, I wasn't able to call in last week. Something came up, and my friend Jiminy was actually looking forward, but he's not here. So anyway, in regards to this whole thing going on, I had a couple thoughts, and I hope I can formulate it good enough that it comes out clear and precise. So this whole thing that's happened over the last year, you know, I always say, look at what happened and what the end result winds up being. Mm-hmm. And so I did a little research, and, there is 6,164 hospitals in the United States,
okay.
And worldwide 164,000 hospitals. That's hospitals, however many people are in there, whether beds are empty or not.
Sure.
Now, is it possible that this whole agenda, the thing that was pushed this last year, is it enough for these two things to be true, or at least plausible, that if that many hospitals are closed down and no one's able to go in, does that not mean, I mean, doesn't that mean that is a potential of 6,000 times however many people in there of no eyewitnesses of the treatment that the elderly are receiving in our hospital.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And if that's the case, I mean, Eve, think about it. If it's something they're going to do slowly, even over 10 years, so even if they just do one or two or three people a year, but every year it increases by year 10, by year 20, 30,
right.
You know, people are dying even, you know, even if it's 20, 40, 50 extra people in a hospital, and you do that over a year's time, you know, that's anywhere from one a month to five a month. I mean, you just do the math, it's exponential. And wouldn't it also take care of another problem that the three of us were in our, well, I can't speak for Karen, I forget how old you are, so, she's 29. And me, Mark, are in our mid, you know, okay, that's okay, maybe not. But, you know, there's a problem that has been discussed since we've been in our 30s, at least. And that's the Social Security problem, the supposed funding and non-funding and all that. Well, wouldn't that be killing two birds with one stone if the elderly over the next 10 years are eliminated?
Bird, by the way, in England means woman, or it's a slang for woman. The right, Roxanne, is that right?
Slang for woman. What did you say?
Bird.
Bad. Yeah.
Yeah. And that makes sense, man. Because people have been, as you know, if you get sick in the States, and you don't get any hospital visitors, and it's very possible. We don't know what's happening behind closed doors. I mean, my uncle, who was pushing 90, pneumonia and stroke victim, he had no visitors. They could do anything they want. You don't get to sit next to the bed of your family.
Anything done in secret is unverifiable, right? Wouldn't you guys agree to that?
Right, absolutely.
And then the last thing, and Karen, I'd really love to hear your little take, and I'll be done.
Okay.
That with this vaccine, in the same thing, if they slowly roll it out, Mark, if you know what you know about the AI, anybody who's been online or has an electronic presence, there's a profile. They know everything about us, right? Well, if they know that we have certain beliefs, and they know if we're a flat earther, meaning we are awake and we're not believing nothing, well, would it be possible that they wouldn't even need doctors to basically do? They wouldn't be knowingly doing any harm, just like that experiment. But if the vaccines have several, what do we call
it? The Milgram experiment. Well, I got you.
What if somebody way up at top, and the scary part is, what if it is AI? What if it is an algorithm? This guy gets this strain, and he gets the shot, and oh my goodness, look at, he died from these side effects, which would also explain the reason why we've been watching for 10 years commercials about these crazy drugs and all the side effects. Right. And that's the programming, so that when people start dying, well, it happened because of the side effect.
Yeah.
But hey, the person that happened to die, well.
By the way, if you want Karen to answer, you better stop soon, because we're running out of time.
Okay, I think I made my point, Karen. I think does that make sense? What I'm getting at.
I think so.
What he's getting at is, you know, is it possible that the hospitals could be laying out? I mean, as you know, there's been all sorts of theories about what the vax could and could not do. But yeah, you're right. Using the Milgram example, could they be inadvertently, thinning the herd, as it were? Yeah. 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 Very possible.
Yeah, I think. Yes.
Using the nanotechnology and the DNA and all that.
Sure.
I mean, my goodness. Yes. And then one other side of that coin, really fast, what if they did map the DNA? They are able to turn things on. They can give a super strength. Well, what happens if the evil people find out that don't laugh at me, but there's a lot of superhero movies in the last, starting from 20 years ago to today, to a fever pitch, from X-Men to DC and comic. Well, what if people start having super strength and living forever, and then they go, now I do want it, the opposite of what we're thinking, but they'll live longer and they won't die and are willing to go that route. That parallels Noah when he was the only one that wasn't corrupt, and that man is trying to rewrite and become gods without God doing it. So that's my other side of that coin. So that's it. So shout out to Jaron and David Weiss and, you know, Owen Benjamin. Why not? Yeah. Casey Blissman. and Zulu One and Jan. Okay. She's nice. All right, guys. Well, God bless you. Hang in there. Oh, and you know what? Rob Skiba. Don't know what happened to him, but
he's around.
Oh, well.
He's around.
All right. Thanks, man.
Yeah. All right,
yeah, they're definitely doing that with the vaccines. And they're definitely trying to play God, and they're trying to make life. I mean, if you watch any of these talks that they give, they always talk about how they're trying to create life. It's called Synthetica.
Yeah. There you go. We'll be back in 3 for the final segment.
Yeah.
Roxanne's going to stay awake. I know it.
I am.
Yeah.
Real people, real radio. Wherever you are, make it TFR.
Truth Frequency Radio.
Welcome back to Strange World, part 4 of 4. It's you, me, Karen B, and that wonderful woman out in UK who stayed up really late. She didn't even really go to bed. I mean, I know she had a little nap, but she's up now. It's 4:30 in the morning in London, and that's Roxanne. Roxanne, you still there?
I sure am.
You know what we're going to do? Because this show kind of goes off the rails when we take phone calls, we're going to do your plugs right now.
Cool.
Yes.
And buy that, because you deserve it. Other people, not so much. No. You, though, absolutely deserve it. So what we're going to do is, those of you who just tuned in, this is Roxanne Glenn. Your YouTube channel is called?
It's called Really Woke Roxanne. However, because of the community guidelines, that channel and all of my other Really Woke show channels on YouTube are under 2 community guideline strikes at the moment.
Uh-oh.
So unfortunately, I'm not going to be able to put any content on any of those channels for the next 90 days. However, you can find us at The Really Woke Show on Facebook. You can all find us at The Really Woke Show on Twitter. You can also find us at The Really Woke Show Live and The Really Woke Show UK on Instagram. And you can find us on Stand Up Sorry as well on Instagram. And you can also get us on our website, www.thereallywokeshow.com. You can sign up for free. It takes 2 minutes. All you need is an email address and an online username, and you can get access to most of our content. The only thing that we get people to sign up for membership is for banned content that we have to download, re-upload, and put on there. It's a shame that they take it down, actually. It's like modern day book burning, like digital book burning, like live stream shows, like interactions that happen on the road, like evidence of police brutality. They just remove it. They burn it like books.
Wow.
So yeah, that's all the places that you can
do. Do you have a Patreon thing, or if anyone wants to donate to your cause?
We have a donation link on the website. You can go straight through to the donation link, or you can sign up for membership for monthly, quarterly, annually, or lifetime. There's various bits and pieces that you get if you do that. Or yeah, you can just donate. We don't have a Patreon or a GoFundMe or anything like that.
All right. Well, would it be okay if we gave out your email address if somebody wanted to reach out to you?
That's roxanne@thereallywokeshow.com.
All right. This is where I turn into my TV evangelist moment. I did it for Dottie. In fact, we'll pick up Dottie right after this, because we got Dottie to fly out to Karen's conference. By the way, Karen, you know, did this wonderful conference out in the United States, the only Flat Earth conference of 2020. And it was stupendous. There were at least, 400 people without masks for
400.
For days, and the entire staff of the building, which had nothing to do with us, it was the Shriners building, nobody wore a mask. It was a completely maskless event, and I think only half of us died. Pretty sure. Only about half. No. Nobody. Not only did nobody die, fine, it was 1 in 3. Not only did nobody die, nobody got sick. as far as I know. I don't know any, you know, we would have had phone calls, I think, pretty much on the air. It'd be like, I went to your damn conference. Now, you know, five of my family's dead. No, nothing happened. Oh, yeah, there's a link for the donations, the Really Woke Show. Oh, sorry, I got to be the TV evangelist for 1 second. Friends, brothers and sisters, if you're listening to me now, you know, I don't care. You want to send me care packages? That's great. My physical address is on every video I make. However, I am not doing street activism like Roxanne is doing street activism. I do it every once in a while, you know. But Roxanne is out there. She is on the front lines. She is doing what most Americans don't. And that is she's putting herself out there in the thick of it. Front line of the truth community. And for that, you should donate.
Yes.
Give your time. Give whatever. Keep Roxanne on the street. That didn't sound right. But
no, that's okay. I prefer being on the streets. I was covering the Julian Assange trial the other day. We managed to cover Stella giving a statement as well. Obviously, the extradition didn't go down and bail was denied, but he's still trying to go for bail. He could be a free man soon. Watch well, this space.
Roxanne needs your support, and that's why I'm making sure of you. Who cares about me? You know what? But when it comes to Roxanne, I value her life more than my own in this case. Because she's doing what I cannot. I'm stuck on an island up north of Seattle. I'm practically in Canada, which is not in great shape either. But UK, they are point. You know, they are the tip of the spear. Everybody in America could take lessons from what the UK is doing in the truth community. And Roxanne, you're my go-to person. I was going to say guy, but then again, you know, all God's children. I'm not trying to gender anybody. Right. So,
cheers,
that being said, who haven't we picked up? Oh, yeah, I was going to pick up Dottie, and then we'll go out to California again. But first, Dottie in Seattle. 360, Dottie, are you there?
Hello, hello. There's no place I'd rather be on a Tuesday night.
Is there any other place you can be on a Tuesday night?
Well... last week, I made you hurry up and pick me up so that I could go to work. And then on Thursday, I got fired. So now I have nowhere to be.
Dottie, so, why did you get fired?
Because I am a deadly nana killer, super spreader, non-mask wearer, and I would not comply with the company's policy that they said I had to wear a mask. I even went and spent 50 of my own dollars to get a doctor's note saying that I was exempt from wearing a mask. And the manager that I work with all the time, he had zero problem with the fact that I didn't wear a mask. I brought him my doctor's note and he said, wow, I didn't even notice that you don't wear one. I guess that shows how much I care. But it was the small man above him who decided that I was not allowed to be in the building. And so... they let me go. And so here I am again. 6 months without a job. I worked for a week and now I'm without one again. So I'm on a roll.
Is that legal if you have a doctor's note? I mean,
right now it's sort of a gray area. Nobody knows exactly what.
This is a clown world. This shit is insane.
I know. All Dottie did was lick the door handles of everybody in that office, and they just freaked out.
Totally unacceptable. Yeah. Apparently discrimination is now allowed. I mean, I know that I could fight it through HR, but like at this point, you know, it's like, what really is the point? Like, I don't have just an abundance of time to wait for like my bills to stack up. And, you know, I don't know, just some things that like aren't worth fighting. And I'm like, okay, well, I'll just leave. That's fine. And honestly, at this point in the last 6 months, flat earthers have supported me more than anyone else ever in my life financially. I mean, people went out of their way to buy my domes. They donated incredible amounts of money to me to get me to Flattoberfest. They were unbelievably generous at Flattoberfest by donating to me, by buying my domes. And I mean, at this point, like, I think maybe I should just stick with that because I can do it out of my house and people really seem to enjoy it. So, like, right. Hey, if you want a flat earth dome, you can email me, dottieswonderdomes1111@gmail.com. And
did you pick 1111 to suck up to Karen? Is that what you did?
I mean, it's just really good lucky numbers. Like, it's Dottie's Wonder Domes 1111. Yep, at gmail.com.
At gmail.com.
And so, yeah, I mean, huge shout out to you, Karen, and Roxanne. Like, you two are just unbelievable champions in this crazy world. You know, you just, neither of you take any shit, and you just keep trucking along and doing what you know is right. And you're both very inspiring to me. And I just really try to, you know, think about what you two would do and just not back down from stuff that I know is right. And, but yeah, I mean, it gets really hard when I feel like the world just keeps like kicking me in the face, but yeah. You know, I, for whatever reason, I was not meant to be at that warehouse anymore. So I'm just moving forward. So yeah.
Good for you, Dottie. Seriously.
Well done you, sweetheart.
Yes.
Yeah, and again, honestly, it wouldn't have mattered much anyway, because when the vax program starts rolling out, it's a whole new level of weirdness. Because then, again, the masks, that was just a placeholder. Yeah. Although I've heard there's a lot of people that are saying, oh, no, you still got to wear the mask even though you get your shot on top of it. So whatever.
It's insanity. None of it makes any freaking sense.
Nope. It does not. That's what makes
it
so fun.
It blows my mind how many people just go along with all this crap.
Yeah, they're just, yeah, exactly. Well, I mean, you and I have discussed it for months and months, which is they can change the rules at any time and people just roll with it. I will use the same, in fact, that's partly Dottie's name. I will use the same line that I said before. I said, if starting next Monday, they said that polka dot masks actually protected you better than regular masks, there would be a run at every hobby store in the country for polka dot fabric. And there'd be companies just cranking them out and people would be wearing them. Why? Because they're sheep. So save yourselves. Try not to save anybody else at this point because they're all doomed. All right. Anything else, Dottie?
Dottie, what was your email again?
It's dottieswonderdomes1111@gmail.com.
Okay.
Dottie's Wonder Domes 1111@gmail.com. And she'll send you some wonderful, wonderful Wonder Domes.
Putting it in my chat.
Now with 30% more opium. Yeah.
You know it.
What? What? I smoked mine. You guys didn't? What do you think those sparkles were? All right.
Exactly. You said
they were glitter. I disagree. All right, Dottie. Hey, you have a good night. Stay tough. We'll talk soon.
Bye. Love you guys.
All right,
Dottie, take care.
We're gonna go back to the other side of the country, out to New York. Let's go to 917. Are you in New York and are we talking about something? And you better say something nice to Roxanne because I don't want her to fall asleep.
I am not in New York now, North Carolina. Roxanne, you're awesome, as are you, Karen, and you too, Mark. You guys are all phenomenal.
Perfect.
Thank you.
Now, Mark, I heard your rant twice, loved it, with the blue and red team.
Thank you.
I want to ask you a question now. So I think it's more likely that it will be a blue team scenario. Whether that's fortunate or unfortunate, you know.
It's certainly leaning blue because everybody, if mainstream is blue, then what do you think they're going to say? They're going to say, oh, we've got this. We've got this. We've got this. But my grandfather told me till it happens, it hasn't. So I don't know if he really had that.
True. It hasn't happened yet. These next 8 days are going to be very tumultuous and interesting and we'll see what happens, but let's just say that, you know, things, you know, do turn out that way as, you know, you'd expect.
Yeah.
You did comment that it's over, quote unquote, for the red team. Not that I disagree necessarily. However, I do think it is possible that you will see some Star Wars Empire Strikes Back type resistance movements unfolding.
Very possible.
And it'll be interesting.
Yeah, very possible. I mean, at this point, everything is on the table as far as the response goes. I just know that, look, if you can control an election, and not just at the federal level, but at the state level with Georgia, then you can do anything. I mean, that's it. As far as...
Well, the scary thing is they stole the national election.
Oh, yeah. God, yes. Oh, yes. Why wouldn't you?
Clearly.
I mean, in fact, I was wondering, as I was thinking about it before 2020 happened, I was thinking, wait, why didn't they do this earlier? They could have done this back years ago. And who knows, you know, maybe the power play just wasn't quite set up yet. But this point running forward, yeah. Look, now what I'm a big believer in formulas, meaning once the formula works and you know it works, you don't deviate from it. You just run it. And I think that's what they did with Georgia. It was like all these people, unexpected. Georgia was a complete blue, you know, thing. And even though it was really close, it was really within 1%. And people are like, wow, really? So, yeah, which means you can do this for any state. So, anyway, yeah, that's what I'm thinking. Turning.
What are your thoughts on perhaps, you know, states like Texas and Florida?
Oh, seceding?
Kind of, secession? You know, going their own way.
Type stuff? That'll take a little while, you know, talk about your act of Congress. Wouldn't that be ironic? You know, Texas that wanted to be its own country 150 years ago now actually may do it.
Yeah, the Lone Star State.
But what would have to happen there is they would have to object to national policies that would really affect their state. So, you know, that there will be all sorts of new policies that are going to be rolled out very, very quickly if it goes blue. And does the state all of a sudden, you know, say, well, you've got to convince your populace in that state that it's better for you to secede and become your own thing? It's maybe. I mean, sure. Why not? If anyone's interested, this was written in an 80s graphic novel 20 something years ago called Give Me Liberty by Frank Miller. You know, famous graphic novel guy who wrote 300 and Dark Knight Returns and basically reinvented Daredevil and Spider-Man and stuff like that. So check it out if you get a chance.
Interesting, yeah. I will. Yeah. I will.
All right. Anything else?
Well, I appreciate you guys. Yeah. Great show as always. Thank you.
All right. Have a good one. Talk soon. Don't be a stranger.
You too, guys.
Yep.
Thank you.
So Roxanne just fired off some stuff in chat. What am I looking at? U.S. House.
Yeah, it's just come in. I've just come across it. So it looks like the U.S. The U.S. House approves the resolution calling on Vice President Pence to convene and mobilize the cabinet to invoke the 25th Amendment. And simultaneously, Google have just suspended Trump's YouTube channel, and they've said that he can't upload for a week. They've just given him a community guideline strike.
Nice. Yeah, we'll see what tomorrow brings. Again, with anything, yeah, the peanut gallery says have to wait for the Senate now. Things like this do, like with anything in government, it does take a little time. And for them to impeach in 8 days would take some doing. And the fact that they're even doing it means there's something else behind the scenes. It kind of goes into my competitive thing, the rant. They don't want it just to win. They want to wipe out the other team. And if they could pull this off, yeah, it means Congress would have to work, yes. If they could pull this off, then the red team would be decimated. I mean, it's adding, you know, the term adding insult to injury. That's what this would be. It's like, not only did we win, we got your guy out before it was even over, if you can pull that off. So.
Looks like there is now. I'm looking at a video feed.
It's not a complete shock what they did there, but part of that was because, and I know we're not really supposed to talk about it right now, was because of the Capitol thing, which it seems like a huge bunch of theater. I don't want to get into the details too much, but
I'm with you on that with the theater.
It was a perfect
major theater,
perfect timing for that to happen, and all they had to do was bait the red team faithful into going. Like I was telling DITRH, I said, I said the rally was just a smokescreen for the violence, you know, because you needed a rally to act as cover. And then that the violence was just to sway, you know, politicians sway so quickly. They bend so quickly, especially when the, you know, it's in their backyard. You know, nobody's been in the Capitol forever to do anything. And so, you know, then you can get your people, you go in, it's like, you should change your vote. And, you know, just politician on politician. It's like, see what's happening out there. If you don't vote the right way, this whole thing could blow up. And yeah. Fun. Thank you, Roxanne, for giving those.
No worries.
We got to take at least one more call. Sorry. Jeez, there's so many calls, guys. I don't know. Jan and Dallas, you know what? Let's take Jan real quick. Jan, yes. Are you there? 214.
Hi, guys. Special hello to Roxanne. And I'm so glad the gentleman before said this was stolen, because it was. But there's proof, but it doesn't matter. But I still believe that God gave us President Trump. He's not a politician. He's a businessman. And I believe he's going to win out, because I believe he's very smart and has good people around him, Michael Flynn and so forth. That's it.
All right. Well, thank you, Jan.
I hope so.
Yeah, we'll see.
We don't want the other team in there, do we? It starts with a C and has another C and a P in it.
Thank you, Jan. Very nice.
Hang up now.
All right, we'll talk soon. Okay.
Right.
All right. See ya. Bye, Jan.
Awesome.
I'm gonna pick up New York to end the show, but I want, you know, there's a call that came in and my screen seems to be flickering. I don't know. Am I being hacked? What's happening? What's happening right now? 920, are you there? Are you hacking my computer right now?
Sure, why not?
Is this Belarus?
Yes, it is.
We haven't heard from you in a while. Are you pleased that America is going down this path?
Well, I actually wanted to be serious today for change.
Serious? Okay. Well, do it. You got about 90 seconds because I do have to pick up New York. So go. What do you got?
Damn.
Sorry. What? You called late. Not my fault. Get off my back. It's my show.
Sometimes you have a choice.
What? Quick, say something. You haven't called in months.
I have a story to tell. Well, you know, January 6th, there were these supposed riots and takeover of the Capitol, and all the politicians were terrified and scared for their lives and all that.
Yeah.
Well, come January 7th, I have to do some shopping. And I go in the store and I take what I need and stand in the line. Well, one of the people who works there comes up and whispers, "You should really wear a mask." And I whisper back, "I don't have one." Anyhow, I generally don't wear a mask. If they ask me nicely, I can put one on sometimes, because I understand that they're little people too, and sometimes they have their managers breathing down their necks.
Yeah.
Or when you see like the old right of high school girl who's not sure, and she knows she has to ask everybody, and she's so nervous. Like, why not? You know. So he says, "Well, I can get you one." And he brings one out from whatever it is. Of course, it has fingerprints all over and doesn't matter anyhow.
Yeah.
And then he leans in and says, "Because, you know, you look like you're about to start a riot."
Oh, nice.
And that was the top in it.
Nice. Yes.
Yeah. True
Very
story.
Good. Hey, I hate to do this to you, but unfortunately, I've got to wind up the show. Call earlier next time, will you? Where have you been? other than rigging the election and, you know, starting the chain reaction that brings down the entire United States. Damn Russians. I don't know what's with you guys.
My circumstances change. Anyway, I can't always call in.
I know. Say goodbye in Russian. Say goodbye in Russian for me.
Okay. До свидания.
There you go.
До скорых встреч.
See ya. Call me on my private line sometime, okay?
Maybe. I don't know.
Whatever. Talk soon. Okay. Last call. Ooh, gotta do this quick. This is New York, so I gotta sing. Roxanne probably knows this. The sun will come out tomorrow. Bet your bottom dollar that tomorrow
there'll be sun tomorrow.
It's I'm like only hearing being a nice trombone hit a low note. I swear to God.
You have a guess, so I'm being nice. Hey, Roxanne, I love you. Karen, I love you. Mark, I love you. Peanut Gallery. You're awesome. You guys, all of you are inspirational. I mean, really, we are all like trapped, and it's so important to know we are not alone. Oh my God.
Yeah.
Like we always say, you know, I'm rampage ready. It's just ridiculous. Yep, ridiculous out there.
Yeah.
Hey, cool. I wanted to say real quick, shout out to William. I always forget. I'm such a dick. I apologize. I love you, William. You're awesome. And I corroborate all the LE stuff, law enforcement stuff he says, all the first responder stuff. He's accurate. I agree. I mean, not that I'm anybody other than just another guy that does this stupid shit. And I wanted to say hello to him because I always forget. I'm sorry.
That's all right.
And you
That's
guys right. are awesome. And
Very
Roxanne,
cool.
Roxanne, I don't know how you do it. I don't know how you're up at 4. Well, I don't sleep anymore either. This shit's got me so angry. It's ridiculous.
Patriots don't sleep, right?
Yeah, there you go. Yeah. And it's 5 and it's 5 a.m. there now. Oh. So we got to stay on the line, Zulu,
because
we got
to Pelosi.
Yeah.
Pence sent a letter to Pelosi, said he won't impeach him.
Okay, I saw that. And by the way, Roxanne, thank you for sending me Elon Musk's latest post. That is freaking creepy. If you guys haven't checked it out, that's really, really weird. Zulu, stay on the line because we are closing down the show right now. Remember, donate to Roxanne if you get a chance. And the music hasn't queued up, so say goodnight, Karen.
Good night, Karen.
Say goodnight, Roxanne.
Love you all. Handle each other with care. And thank you for having me.
Roxanne, you got a lot of props from the people in chat. Everybody appreciates all the things you do, all
Big
your activism,
you.
All your work. We love you.
Right
Big
on.
Love
Same
you more.
Same flat time. Same flat channel next week. Say goodnight, Zulu.
Goodnight, Zulu. Shout out to Dottie's World, Hidden Truth, Constance, everybody. Love you guys. Bye.